the Waitomo River?
Waikato
River.
Yeah.
Wai is water, and Keto is flowing.
Oh, I see.
Makes no sense, because I'm not moving it very quickly.
Our registered expert here, Adam, driving us along.
Let's not get carried away with
that. And pretty exclusive trip. Yeah, it's just the two of us this time. So.
VIP, they paid for this exclusively.
So, here's a little bit what we're looking at. So we're just cruising down right now. We're heading off into a place called The Squeeze. And thinking thin thoughts. All right, until next week.
Taupo originally being a volcano, it's actually erupted 17 times. The last one was only 1800 years ago, and so in between those eruptions there would have been trees which would have been grown, and then they would have just suddenly got buried by a whole lot of volcanic material. And then so over time the soil compacts around them, and then the tree rots away, and what it does is it leaves holes and amongst the ground where there would have been their trunk, or would have been smaller holes where it would have been their branches. So all of that kind of stuff is right on the edge of the bank, but it's also underneath the river surface. Okay, we've got a perfect example of these holes just up here.
Oh yeah, yeah.
Okay, so if you can imagine those kind of holes underneath the river surface, imagine an eel finding those holes and going, oh, what's up there? And going inside it and not being able to get out. Now all the Māori warriors of this time, they knew where those holes were from just exploring previously. They just reach in,
right.
Here's an eel, pull it out,
dinner,
no trap required. So tutuko, no trap.
Yeah. Okay. So that's good. That's cool.
Fishing here was very, very easy.
Yeah.
Imagine. Awesome.
All right. So
nobody likes. I mean, they could grab the eels, even if it's the tail end, but still, they're so prehistoric and creepy looking. I don't think I could grab anything
they
out of a hole like that.
Especially when they...
I've never had one, so are they tasty?
Yeah, only if they're smoked. When they're smoked, they're really nice, but some people boil them. In China, they boil them. And
chewy, right?
If you boil it. Gross, man, gross. I mean, no one even boils fish. It's just don't do it. But it's considered a bit of a delicacy in China. So we actually sell a heap of them to China. But over here now we smoke them.
That was delicious.
About trying to imagine what this river would have looked like before they constructed the dams. Now at the end of the gorge here, you can actually see the water stirring up a wee bit. So there used to be a giant series of rapids at the end there before they built the dams and flooded it out. And all the invading parties that wanted to take over this land, they were too afraid to come across the land. Just for the horror stories of war parties that had gone on before them, lost their way, and just ended up finding themselves in a very hazardous thermal area, you know, where the land could just literally crumble underneath your feet and swallow your boiling death. You know, and this isn't something you need to imagine. This happens every few years when people jump the fences in the thermal areas and all that. So the ground is very unstable, and this only had to happen a few times for the word of fear to get put out there.
Yeah.
So all these invading parties figured the safest way to come here is straight down the river. Of course, you don't know about those rapids.
Until it's too late.
So they come around the corner, suddenly be in this gorge, not be able to climb out of here, not be able to paddle back upstream.
Yep.
So they're stuck right here. And they always had scouts on the banks, keeping an eye on the river. And when they found these invading parties in here, they could assess the situation. They're always looking for if they brought their women and children. It's a bit of an indication that they're probably here to do some trading with you. You know, no one's going to take their kids into battle. And women were with a bit to trade back in those days. There's no polite way to put that. So yeah. You can't get rid of the natives anymore.
You can't.
Look at this guy. Him, but you can't kill his laugh.
So that was a man-made thing?
I did that with one already.
You couldn't look at me in the eye when he said that. So was this a man-made cave?
No, that was a natural... We're really quiet. We'll hear a stream.
Oh, I do hear it.
So there's a spring inside that cave.
Listen
with this ear.
Yeah. Now I'm right.
But I do hear it.
Yeah.
I can hear it.
Yeah, so there is a spring inside that cave, so it's completely natural.
I see. That's even more fantastic. I love it. Looks like some of these are ready to go.
That one on that rock, it's been like that for the entire 8 years that I've been here.
Okay. But I see a crack through the bottom.
That appeared about 18 months ago.
Okay, so maybe.
Just waiting for the right gust of wind, I think.
I love it. I love it. Fantastic. We could just stay here all day.
That's a hot waterfall.
Nice.
So the locals have actually built that rock dam at the base of it, turned it into a natural hot spa. So a great place to hang out after a day's wakeboarding or water skiing, and then just hang out anywhere with a box of beers.
No kidding. Why wouldn't you?
Yeah. Sounds brilliant.
Great place for a hot date. You get access to a boat.
The man who knows.
Didn't call it the gap.
Oh yeah.
Wow.
Yeah, you probably have to be careful if you have an extra belly or something on you can't quite get through here, huh?
Yeah. Now, my boss wouldn't let me put up a sign at the office saying no fat chicks.
If I was not drilling up.
Indiana Jones adventure.
Yes.
Into to tell me so.
amazing.